Hey, welcome back, everybody. Cyan here again with another episode of Material Energy Classic. And I should probably make sure to hook these up whenever I get my power going. Although, at the same time, I could just run cables from there over to here, so not that important. And not like I really use the spatial I/O system anymore, at least not this one. Especially now I have a mob farm set up in there, and a good portion of the mob farm components don't get picked up. So, but I went ahead. I've got myself a magma crucible now. And we're going to need this for a few things. But for now, let me get started with some Enderium so I can get some test racks made up. You and you. So yeah, tesseract. The frame is four Enderium, four hardened glass, and a diamond. Then we have to fill it with basically four ender pearls with a resonant ender, and then we have to clad it in silver and bronze. So they're kind of involved. We do need though a fluid transposer, one of these guys. We're also going to need an induction smelter. I'm feeling I already made an induction smelter, didn't I? Oh well. Nope, not there. Induction smelter can go here. That way I can have the fluid transposer next to the magma crucible. And just do that for now. And the reason for that is I need buckets. I also need 40 ender pearls. That's what, 32? 40. You go in here, you're gonna get melted down. Thankfully, these melt fairly quickly. And then we're gonna set you to be input, we're gonna give you a bucket. And boom. Now we have a bucket of resonant ender. I'm gonna go here. You, and a bucket. Dang it. That'll make us Enderium blend. We have some more of those now. Not that. That. And now I also need pyrothium. We have a little bit. Can I make some more up? Missing blaze powder, really. Yeah, I do have a good amount of blaze rods, I just didn't realize I didn't have any blaze powder. Here, 16 should be enough for now. And then Enderium blend plus pyrothium and the induction smelter will make Enderium ingots. That is step one. Well, you're not quite done yet, so. Probably going overkill on the Enderium as well. But, you know, it's something that I might end up using eventually, and I do need a block of Enderium for the Victory Monument, so. This is pretty much all the Enderium I can make, though, because I am out of shiny metal now. Let's see. Can I make ferrous ore? No, I cannot. Okay. So, yeah, that's the thing. Well, here, you can chill out in there for now. Oh, yeah, you ready? Okay. So, if we look at shiny, right? Pulverized shiny metal comes from platinum or shiny ingots. Platinum ore or ferrous ore. So that means deep dark, which is one of the reasons I'm doing this. I should be able to find, if not platinum, then at least the Ferrozoar in the deep dark. And one last one. Now, yeah, we got a full stack of blaze powder. That'll be good. There you go. There's some sulfur. There's that. You can have that and that now. And there. That is the last of our Enderium dust. Total of 40 pieces of Enderium. So, it's technically 10 tesseracts worth. How are my enderpearls doing? Not quite great yet, huh? Harvested them not long before I started recording, so. Well, I got four more here. All right, cool. And time for trash to go away, looks like. Looks like our barrel is full of string. Have to get some upgrades done for the barrels too. I'll worry about that off camera. It's mainly just going to take a good amount of wood, so. Which, tree farm. I haven't checked on the tree farm yet. It's not been that long though, since yeah, I did maybe 10 minutes of off camera work before I started recording, so. That number's gone up, hasn't it? 11 stacks. 4.5 stacks of coal now. Okay. Why are you out of power? Oh, because I'm an idiot. That's why. I never hooked the generator up to everything else. So everything came basically to screeching halt, which explains why we have so much more wood now. All right. That works. Alright, so that's all taken care of. I can put at least those away for now. I'm probably going to need another magma crucible since I'm going to be using this for crafting. I need one of you. Lead. Yeah, I need to get the deep dark stuff going here sooner than rather than later. I need lead for hardened glass too. Yeah, I have one lead ingot and I have 10 lead nuggets. So, what do I have for obsidian? Right. Yeah, a decent amount. You go there, that's done. Victory Monument. Thermal expansion metals. I just need a lead block now. Which is slightly problematic, but we will work with that. You plus you. There we go. That'll make me some hardened glass anyway. And Enderium. I mean, it's actually filling up rather nicely. Definitely could be better though. Let's check in here. I think this probably come to a screeching halt. Yeah. There are just too many ghasts for me to just go mining for right now. It's not so much dealing with the gas once I get down there because I can just tunnel in. It's just getting down there with all those ghasts in the area. Georgia of grade one. Can I make any of those? And I also need a frame, right? It's you, and then there's you. Go fix our string issue real quick. If I let it go too long, then it's gonna. I'm still not despawned. I picked up a helmet. Didn't mean to. There's. Oh, that's my shift right quick. And we'll just do one, two, three. That'll hold 16,000 items. Alright, I mean, we're getting a lot of creeper hits too for some reason. No idea why. We'll take that and that though. It's an eye of Ender because why not? I do have that, so let me get a lever. Grab you as well. And I'm going to need compression dynamos. I have one. Transmission coil, need silver, that's fine. I have eight fluid ducts. I'll figure this out whenever I get there. Right, so let me grab you. We are going to expand our platform a little bit. You're still working off the fertilizer too, aren't you? Wow. That fertilizer lasts a hell of a long time. Also, I need an output for sand, which I did not put in yet. Put you here. Don't stop. Hey, look, here comes the sand. Nice. When the dirt wears out, it becomes sand. So that's that whole thing there. All right, so Adam Duct Crucible. And let's see, it'll be extract. Should see coal show up here soon. Oh, I missed a step. Dang it. I need a pulverizer too. I have to pulverize the coal before it can become liquefacted. You know, I keep looking at this, wondering why that is so out there. There's like nothing here. Just like solid. Well, I guess I can patch this hole up finally. That was what, pink, I think, is what was in that one. Yeah, there's just like this big chunk of quartz here for whatever reason. No idea why. Okay. All right, well, but that, can I even go away? have some fuel. All right, pulverizer, magma crucible. On top of the pulverizer now is going to go a better barrel. Because looking at coal, 10% chance of producing sulfur, which I guess I could use for high explosive TNT. Leadstone flux capacitors, okay. I can make gunpowder with it. A few different ways. Ruthenium. Break it down into sulfur, and there's not much point in doing that. The only thing I can really do with it is turn it back into sulfur. And then I'm going to put this drum on top here. And do that. For now, we're going to run these guys back here. To bring the system into... Yep. Bringing it into life, anyway. Boom, look back to coal, goes into the drum. And then from the drum, I can extract it and run it to the compression dynamos. Not much point in me doing that yet, because they're just going to be wasting fuel unless I get a test rack or two up and running first. Well, at least two, right? Move power from one end to the other. And unlike the sequel, this one doesn't just, like, hand out test racks like candy. So. How are my interpearls doing right now, anyway? 37's actually not bad. Okay, that'll be enough for two test racks there. That is enough for one frame. Oh, I had some hardened glass already. Alright, cool. Not remember I had that. Actually, I need you now. You will go here. You will go here. And let that run for a bit. Bronze. Forestry for bronze. Here we go. Get like half stack for now. Now, unfortunately, test rack frames take a little bit to fill up. Oh, there's one. Then I'll do you, like that. There's one tesseract. And there's our second one. Oh, give me a sec. There's two. For now, just on, you know, for the sake of keeping everything running, we are going to put a test rack right here for the moment. We are going to call this channel 1, power, add it in. Yep. There it goes. Man, this rain just does not want to quit. Yeah, power is becoming an issue here, so we got to do something about this. But we've gotten 32 buckets of coal now. So, definite plus. Let me go ahead, we're going to put... You know, we'll do 1, 2, 3 like this. Like that, and then we can do... Fluiduct along the top here. And then I just need another aqueous accumulator. If I had more fluid ducts, I would just pipe into this one over here. But I think it would actually be... Well, I don't know, actually. Fluid ducts probably would be the cheaper option, apparently. Damn, man, I've already got the water sitting there, so... you like that. That should be more than enough. It is still raining. Oh, I need a lever. Dang it. Do we have any cobblestone on me? Because I can get sticks. I don't have any cobble on me. Didn't I just look for that last episode too? I'm sure I did. Bring out one more. We'll do 1, 2, 3. I know you guys are filling up with water. Good, because they need to have a coolant of some kind. And now I need a lever again. I should just keep some of these on me. I need to constantly be able to apply a redstone signal to anything thermal. Come on, there we go. And in this case, I'm just going to put you here. Over there. Boom. Now we have these guys running, producing ADR up a tick. Nothing huge, really, but you know, they are producing power. And now we should be moving power to the rest of the base. Still annoying how the pipes were working yesterday. Seems to be working like a charm, though. Except for the retrieval node sucks. Okay, Speed upgrade. Is there not a stack upgrade in this version? They're kind of expensive too, great. Finally managed to sleep and get the rain to go away. But there is a stack upgrade. I was used to it looking a lot more similar to the speed upgrade, so I overlooked it at first. Yep, there we go. Yeah, it's pulling stacks of a time right now. And keeping an eye on those for a second to see if we're doing a net gain or not. Yeah, it's definitely looked like we're running a net gain on liquefied coal. All right, cool. Means in the future, I maybe could toss another one of these in here. So you still have 3 stacks plus 10 of dirt. Yeah, you should be fine. How is sapling production? Is at 5 stacks. All right. So I just went and made a fermenter and a squeezer. A squeezer is just 10 plus a sturdy casing. Fermenter is bronze. Well, bronze gears plus a sturdy casing, so really not that expensive. I have transfer nodes. That'll have to work, I guess, for now. I'm out of item ducts, is why I bring that up. we go. Run some pipes down now. And I remember these things in the past anyway were pretty strongly sided. Can't remember. Hey, look, you're getting apples. Now I just need to give you power somehow, right? Yeah, see? But there's nothing in the transfer node there. Why are you not pulling? That should be pulling saplings out of this drawer or barrel. Second, there's a redstone signal close by, isn't there? Yeah, right there. See that? Transfer nodes are redstone controlled. I don't think. Well, there's intertransmitters. I don't think there's a ignore redstone option on these things, though. And of course you fell. Well, just do that then. And we'll run like that, so that way it doesn't try to back loop into the barrel. Hey, now we have saplings. Okay. So I need to give this water somehow. Or, you know, a squeezer. With apple juice. Once that gets running anyway. And I also need to give it compost. So that's going to be a thing. Autocrafting of some kind probably would be a smart idea, or I can just put a barrel down here with just tons of compost in it. All right, now I went ahead and made a still as well, which is sturdy casing, redstone glass. I mean, it was the cheapest of the machines. And this thing will convert biofuel, or whatever this is, right? Biomass, into biofuel or something or other. We'll do that. I will go ahead and put a block here. Lever on top. There we go. Now it's flowing like it should. Couldn't throw a torch down. And now we're making ethanol. But now we're going to need biogas engines, which is just bronze, really. I mean, these things are really cheap. We are also going to need, though, a bucket of lava to preheat the biogas engine. And if it ever shuts off for any reason, then, yeah, bad things happen. We have to give it more lava for it to kick back into life. All right, so I've got currently more power than I really know what to do with. And that is because the interquarry has a max arithmetic on it, which unfortunately is not very high. But we went ahead, got everything. I had an issue here. Items were not being pulled quick enough out of here, and it backstuffed pretty much the entire system. So I've got a stack upgrade in there now, and it's working great. Got a good amount of sulfur, too. We are up to 80, basically 86 buckets of liquefied coal, and that number just keeps going up, so three compression dynamos is not a problem for this. Come down to here. Are you currently, like, not doing anything? Why are you not getting any? Oh, I know why. I needed to hook up more stills because one was not able to keep up with the fermenter. And so what it's doing now is it's doing the whole cycling thing. Because transfer pipes are not smart enough to not do that. No way in hell I can just like right click. Oh, I can do that. Okay, that works. There we go. Now we're getting saplings. I forgot that was an option. But the biogas engines only work for biomass. They don't work for ethanol. Ethanol is only for the biogenerator. This guy. This, though, only outputs IC2 power, which is not in this pack, so it's useless. But you can throw ethanol into compression dynamos. And they're doing quite well, actually. I've got three more of them down here. I've got room to put two more in. I'm kind of waiting for it to see, but yeah, we're generating a decent amount of power. We are getting excess mulch from the squishing of apples, which we're actually getting a little low on apples. So, yeah, that's a thing. That'll be fine, though. This is not my main power source, so I'm not too worried about it right now. I really want to, I could, do some crossbreeding of trees with industry and make it so they just drop insane amounts of apples. Yeah, I mean, everything is working exactly how I want it to. So we've got power set up. We got test rack set up. I got a test rack now in the deep dark as well. And that's how I know the quarry's got an RF cap on it, because it's not draining my system to run that quarry. And in this version, in 1.64, there were no quarry upgrades. Know, this is bugging me here too. Makes me feel like I'm gonna hit my head every time I walk through this doorway. Let's see. Checking for safes and so on and so forth. Which there really aren't any. I'm going to basically just let everything just coast. AFK quite a bit. Probably leave this running while I go to sleep tonight. And one thing I'm really kind of worried about is the mob farm. It's going to hit a point where there's not enough storage, so I need to upgrade some of the barrels down there, I guess. But I mean, other than that, we're doing great. I don't know. I'm not gonna ever have to worry about this thing turning off on me again, which is amazing, because that has been such an annoyance. Yeah, I need one bucket on me at any time. And we can use these machines as much as I want now without worrying about killing my AE system. I've actually turned these dynamos off because they're not needed. They were just wasting fuel just as they were. But we have power now, which is great. And since we have power, oh, there's one. Still have not gotten a single extra seed. We can get into some of the other quests in Hell and Nightmares. Yeah, nuclear fission. These things, tungsten plating. Need tungsten, aka wolfram, and beryllium, and a lot of iron. Tungsten doesn't actually have a recipe. Beryllium, however, does. The weird thing is, I'm pretty certain I can get trace amounts of tungsten from cobblestone. But beryllium, I need soul sand. Or beryl, which I can get from emeralds. I get two beryl per emerald, and we get three beryllium per barrel. So just, disintegrate a couple of emeralds and we should have more than enough beryllium for it. It's the tungsten that I'm kind of worried about. But it's, when I say trace amounts, I mean less than a 1% chance per cobble of getting something good out of it. So I'm going to need a decent amount of power to run a molecular, what, disassembler, whatever the hell it's called. This thing. Decomposer. Chemical decomposer. Sorry, the molecular disassembler, that is mechanism. Right? These four strong boxes I've never used. But yeah, I think I'm going to go ahead and call this an episode. One thing I did notice is I am getting potatoes out of my mob farm, means I can switch out wheat, or I can actually just enlarge the farm and put potatoes in as well. Potatoes are a bit of a better food source than bread. More common, anyway. And we do have access to a culinary, right? Yeah, we do. The only downside is the only farm we have is the forestry farms, and we'll have to set up another one of those giant things. But thank you for coming out. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and until the next, the sign signing out. Have fun.